For Meng Shangyi, it's all part of the daily routine, putting on a wash. China's middle classes have become used to the appliances of modern life. For her son, easy comforts are always at hand. As the ranks of China's middle classes swell, greenhouse gas emissions rise with them. But Xiang Yi says you can't blame people for wanting better lives.
他不是采用一个很积极的想积极的方法，然后怎么应对这个，然后怎么解决咱们现有的这个污染这个问题，然后他只是在抱怨其他国家、其他的人民民族，你拥有的别人为什么不能拥有呢？
China's already the world's largest polluter, relying on coal to fuel its economic boom. Although its carbon emissions measured per person are half that of the US, the demand for energy is rising fast. Emissions are not due to peak here for another 20 years. Critics say that by then, it will be far too late to tackle climate change. Analyst Jim Walker says as China develops, it won't agree to any cuts, but it does want to use energy more efficiently.
What you've got now is China making its first commitments on carbon as part of its current government plan for the next 5 years, and that's significant. And the way they're going to make those commitments and meet those commitments on carbon is by starting to really drive energy efficiency in their industrial sectors, but also by gradually increasing the share of low carbon generation, so renewables like wind and solar and nuclear capacity in the energy mix.
China's pouring money into the development of clean technology, driving down costs around the world. But critics say the pace of change isn't happening quickly enough to make a significant difference.
In the future, renewables and clean technology may go a long way to meeting China's energy needs. But for now, it will be coal that continues to fuel the country's breakneck development. Growing prosperity here will lift millions out of poverty, but it's coming at a growing cost to the environment. Martin Patience, BBC News, Beijing.